Now see, we take next example. Now one interesting example I want to take is that generally what we are having x versus t relation. Okay? But nowadays, now we take a sum in which there is a t versus x relation. Let us say it is given as t is equal to ax square plus bx. Okay? Earlier this was asked in one of the competitive exam. See, what you have to find out? Acceleration. Okay? Now, we know v is equal to dx by dt. Okay? So, 1 upon v will be dt by dx. Okay? Now, this will be useful to us. Now, if I take derivative with respect to x, that it will be dt by dx. See, what we are doing here, we are taking derivative with respect to x. So, a x square derivative is 2x, b is constant, derivative of x is 1. Okay, now we know dt by dx is 1 by v, that will be 2ax plus b. Okay, now if I take reciprocal, velocity is 2ax plus b. Okay, now next we have to find out the acceleration. See, in this equation we see there is no term related to t. Okay, why? Because our acceleration is dv by dt. Okay, but what we see here, that there is no term with t, so we have to do something different. So now we know the acceleration is dv by dt. Okay, now we take the help of chain rule that we study in mathematics. What is chain rule? Let me tell you. Suppose it is 3 by 5. See, if I write in this way, 3 upon 7 and y, actually the meaning is same. Here also we have to do the same thing. So what I write here, I write dv by dx into dx by dt. Okay. Now what we have to remember is dv by dx by dt is nothing but our velocity that we have obtained as 2x plus b. Okay, now this will be used. Now v is 1 upon 2x plus b. Okay, now generally we are familiar with the derivative of x is 1. But what will be the derivative of 1 upon x? Okay. See, that is d by dx of x raised to minus 1. So if I use the rule, it will be minus 1 x raised to, okay, see, n x n minus 1. So that will be minus 1 x raised to minus 2 minus 1 upon x plus. Okay, so derivative of 1 upon x is minus 1 upon x plus. So I use the same thing, but dv by dx will be similar to here, minus 2 ax But here there is a term which, instead of x, we have a multiplier also. So there is a rule of the derivative. Whatever the multiplier of x, we have to write again. So what we write here is 2a. So our dv by dx has become minus 2a, 2ax plus b whole square. Okay. Now we come back again here. A is dv by dx into dx by dt. So, I write it again. A is dv by dt, that is dv by dx into dx by dt. Now, dv by dx we have obtained is minus 2a, 2ax plus b whole square into, as I told, dx by dt is velocity, that is v, 1 upon 2ax plus b. Okay, so this will become minus 2a upon 2ax plus b. See, there is 2 power here, 1 power here also. Will be q. See, sometimes the answer is like this. Sometimes the answer is in terms of the velocity. Now, see, 1 upon 2ax plus b is velocity. Minus 2a into v cube. Okay, why? Because v is 1 upon 2x plus b. And here, we can substitute. So this is how we can solve. Now this is a sum in which you have the use this term that is called chain rule in terms of the mathematics or in terms of differentiation. So this is an interesting sum. Yeah, what we saw here, instead of x and t relation, there was t versus x relation. Now, next we take some of the exercise numerical which are remain. Yeah. Now, let us say exercise sum number 3.18. Okay. Now see, the question says a police van is moving with a speed of 30 km per hour. Vp is the velocity. Okay. Now it fires the bullet with a speed of 190. Okay. Now that is the velocity of the bullet. Okay. Now. Okay. See, the question says speed. This is nothing but speed of the thief car. 192. Okay. Now, the muzzle speed of the bullet. See, the bullet is fired from here. 150 meter per second. One important thing you have to keep in mind, whenever we solve such sum, we should have in the same unit system. Okay, we should have the same unit system. We have to, here it is kilometer per hour, here it is kilometer per hour, but the speed of the bullet is 150 meter per second. So what I do, Vp is the 30 into 10, 300. Okay, 300 upon this. Now, what is the both velocity are in the same direction? Okay, that is Vp dash I call as Vp plus Vb. Okay, that is 300. Upon 36 plus 150 meter per second. Okay. Now, here the velocity of thief car is 192 kilometer per hour. Vt I call as velocity of thief, 192 into 10 upon 36. Okay. Now we keep it simple. Okay. Now, what will be the, what is the question says? With what speed the bullet will hit the thief car? So, the velocity with which bullet will hit thief car will be Vp dash minus Vt. Yeah, that is 300 . Okay, now we simplify. Okay, now we try to solve this. 300 final answer is 105 meter per second. Okay, so this is the velocity with which the bullet will hit the thief car. Now if we see the question again, see a police van is moving with the velocity of 30 km per hour. See, a bullet is fired from the police van, okay, with a speed of 150 meter per second. See, the thief van moves with a velocity of 192 km per hour. See, we have to find out with what speed the bullet will hit the thief car. Now here it is in kilometer per hour, this is also in kilometer per hour, but see, the bullet speed is in meter per second. So what we have done here, first we have converted all velocity in meter per second. Now the bullet is fired from the police van, so what is the net velocity of the bullet? That is both velocity from the same reference frame, so we can say it is Vp plus Vb that we have obtained. And the velocity, here is the case of relative velocity, that is Vab will be Va minus Vb, okay. So in that case, the bullet will fire with the speed, see this is 300 upon 36 plus 150, okay, minus 1920 upon 36. And if we solve this, we get 105 meter per second, okay. So this is a exercise numerical 3.18. See, most of the exercise sums are done, okay. Example also we have solved. Now if you have any query, you can ask, okay. Now see, before going for the next lesson, okay, we should summarize, okay. First we talk of the reference frame, then the origin, then we talk of distance and displacement. Okay, distance is a scalar quantity, displacement is a vector quantity. Distance is always positive, displacement may be positive, zero or negative. Okay, now then we talk of speed. Speed is distance upon time. Velocity is okay. Speed is a scalar quantity. Speed is always positive. And velocity is a vector quantity. Can be positive, zero, or negative. See, then we talk of average speed. Okay. Total distance upon total time, okay, and average velocity is displacement upon time. Okay, now we saw some cases for the average speed and velocity, okay. Suppose there is a two-part journey, A and B. Let us say two intervals. Here, distance is same. Then average speed is V1 V2 upon, okay, that we also proved. Suppose there were three equal parts, then we proved okay. Now when time is same, okay, what we see here is a two-part journey. See, for time t, it moves with the speed v1, and time same time it moves with the speed v2. Then average speed okay. Then we talked of distance time graph, that is x versus t graph. Okay, we also saw that slope of x versus t graph gives speed or velocity. Okay, now if x is distance, then we get slope, will get speed. If x is displacement, then we'll get velocity. Then we talked of V versus T graph. Okay, then we saw that slope of V versus T graph, that is generally velocity time graph, gives acceleration. We also saw that area of velocity time graph gives distance or displacement. Yeah, then we talked of uniformly accelerated motion. Yeah, in which we derived three equations. Yeah, v is equal to v naught plus a t. D is equal to v zero t plus half a t square. D is equal to v square minus v zero square. Yeah, these are the three important equations for uniformly accelerated motion. Then we saw for free falling body. Yeah, now there is due to gravitation. So in that case, suppose it is a free falling body, initial velocity will be zero and a is equal to g. So in that case, the equation will pan out v is equal to gt, d is equal to half gt square, d is equal to v square upon g. Okay, we also saw equation for motion in upward direction. Thrown in vertically upward direction. Then the same equation here, v0 will be v0, and because it is moving against the gravitation, the equation will become v0 minus gt, d is equal to v0t minus half gt square, d is equal to v square minus. Okay, then we talked of relative displacement. Okay, we use the equation xf is xi plus vt, xa is x0a, xb final position. Okay, then we obtain the equation. Okay, for what time they meet? Okay, that is xb minus. Okay, and see in final condition, if they meet, xa is equal to x. Okay, then we talked of relative velocity. That is VAB is VA minus VB, or VBA is VB minus VA. We saw four different cases, okay, and we obtained the value of the relative velocity of the. So these are the topics we have covered in this lesson. Okay, now we also saw some question based on the graph, okay, in which we use the property area of the velocity time graph give the distance or a displacement. Okay, so this is all about the lesson number 3, that is the motion in straight lines. This is a very important lesson. See, the kinematics first lesson will be useful in number of lessons. As and when we use in a different lessons, it will be very much useful. Okay, thank you.